guys. Hey guys, I have a grouchy kid here.
And I'm not grouchy.
And it's really hot today, thus pressure cooker life. I have the fan on. I'm sure you guys can hear it. It's on high. It's super hot in here. Let me pop on the iPad here so I can see you guys. Okay, so today I did something new. I never made this dish before. Hi, Dina. I kind of was winging it, and she's super grouchy, so I'm hoping that Rommel is driving fast on his way home from work. Hi, Laura. Hi, Mary. Look, Mama. Hi, Mama. Can you say hi, Mama? Okay, what does she want? What can I give her? Let's give her some Fruit Loops. So that I can finish dinner. I'm making pasta. Hi, Brenda. Hi, Shelby. I'm making pasta for the kids. If Rommel wants, he can have that too. Let's put it in this little cup here. Oh. I have the spaghetti cooking in the pasta maker. I was gonna cook it together with the meatballs, but I decided not to because not everyone's gonna have pasta. So this is something new. I'm gonna post the recipe afterwards. Hi Kupuna, hi Paula, hi Kirsten, hi Rachel, hi Kayla from Saipan. Hi Brenda, in case I didn't say hi Brenda. So I did this in 15 minutes. I did 15 minutes. I'm gonna check for doneness. So what I put in here, it smells really good. I'm gonna show this to you. This is what it looks like before I stirred it, before I'm gonna stir it. So I put a whole bunch of meatballs in here. At the very bottom, I have a layer of Brussels sprouts for Rommel because I know he likes Brussels sprouts. And then I topped it with a little oregano, like fresh oregano, 3 or 4 leaves of oregano. I just kind of sliced it with the scissors. And then a little bit of fresh garlic, some garlic salt and pepper. And then that's when I covered it with the meatballs. This is about 2.5 pounds of meat. And all I did was mix the meat with onion soup mix and an egg. That's all I did. And I formed them into meatballs like this. And I'm actually gonna put this in for another maybe 5 to 10 minutes. I didn't want to overdo it because I've never made this before, and I wanted to be able to stir it with the liquid. So after I put the meatballs in here, I covered it with a can of tomato sauce, and I sprinkled a little bit of Parmesan cheese on top. So let me just check the meatballs for doneness. So I'm stirring it up to mix it all up. The reason I put Brussels in here is because Rommel likes Brussels sprouts, and if he wants to eat the meatballs with the Brussels sprouts, he can do that and eat it without pasta. So that's the, it's kind of hard to see. Let me move this lamp so you guys can see better. Hi, Samantha. So that's the meatballs in a tomato sauce with Brussels sprouts. So let me cut into one, just to make sure it's cooked all the way, because this was cooking for 15 minutes. I just want to make sure that it's done all the way through with the meatballs, because this was a lot of meatballs. And usually with meat, it's 6 minutes per pound, but it's in a pressure cooker, so it cooks a little bit faster. So I'll post the recipe on what I did, because this is something I kind of just came up with. Just want to make sure it's cooked all the way through. Yep, it sure is. So this is one of the bigger meatballs that was in there. So there's no pink. It's cooked all the way through. I did not use breadcrumbs. Ooh. This is good. I could eat this just like this without the noodles. Or if you're a rice eater, you could pour this over rice. I was thinking about making this like a meatloaf where you just put the meat like in the bottom like a meatloaf and then cook it and top it with the sauce. So the sauce came out nice. Not too thin. I added like maybe 1/3 cup of water. That was all the water I put in. The rest of this is the tomato sauce and any liquid that came out of the meatballs. So it doesn't really need any thickening. Oh my gosh, this came out really good. This pressure cooker is the winner. I love this pressure cooker. I haven't had anything really not turn out good in the pressure cooker in the 3.5 years I've been using it. Oh, you can make a meatball sub. That's a good one. Okay, this is beef, Kristen. Okay, so let me put this on. The spaghetti noodles are done. I use my microwave pasta maker to do this. This is an old one, which is why it's blue. So it cooked in the microwave uncovered for 15 minutes. I put it in for 15 minutes. And I'm going to drain the liquid out. So when you drain it on the pasta maker, on one side there's holes. You can kind of see it a little bit. And then you want to point the arrow to the holes. And then we're going to tip this into the sink and drain it. So I'm going to turn this a little bit so you guys can see. So I don't cook pasta on the stove anymore. I use Tupperware's pasta maker because it's so much easier. Because you can easily wash this out or throw it in the dishwasher if you have a dishwasher. So it's all drained. Here's my spaghetti noodles. I only did two servings. And I'm going to show you the inside of this in a minute. I'm actually going to transfer these noodles into a bowl. So that I can dress this with the sauce and the meatballs for the kids. So there's the pasta noodles. It didn't get like, you know how it bunches up? It didn't bunch up. It did. There's no hard like pieces at the bottom. Oh, use it in the sauce. The sauce is pretty watery already. So I don't think I need to add any more liquid to the sauce. So there's the spaghetti noodles. So I want to show you this pasta maker, the microwave pasta maker. They make two different shapes. This one's the rectangular one. I'm not sure. I can't remember if they're selling the round one in the catalog still. It was out last catalog. So the pasta maker actually has markings molded into the plastic. And it might be hard to see in here. It might be hard for me to try and show it to you guys in here. Oh, instead of adding plain water, yeah, it's different when I'm using the pressure cooker because I cook this first and I cook this second, so it's a little bit different. But the measurements are molded into the plastic, and I'm gonna have a hard time trying to depict this for you guys. I might have to like pull pictures of it or Google images online, but it's molded. So on this side it has 1, 3, and 5. This side has 2, 4, and 6. And it has a straight line at the bottom and a wavy line at the top. So the straight line at the bottom is how much pasta, like how many servings you're making. And so you would put your spaghetti up to that line, and then you would add water up to the wavy line, the corresponding wavy line in that graph, I guess. And then you would put this in your microwave and cook it between 15 to 18 minutes uncovered, just like you would boil it on the stovetop. And then like what you saw me just do, you would put this on and drain it, then you can serve it. You could leave it in here for serving. I'm putting it in a bowl because I'm going to put the sauce and stuff on it so that the noodles absorb the sauce for the kids. And so yeah, I know like when you're cooking your pasta, people use their pasta water. I've never done that in all the years I've done pasta because I don't know, I'm a Filipino. Okay, so somebody's at the door. Yay. Somebody is here actually to pick up their bowl, so I'll be right back. Can you bring her in the box and then just get the microphone? Tell her I'm live right now. Bring that box to her, the box of bowls. Pick it up. Don't drag it. I'm live right now. So, I've never done pasta water in my sauce, but that's because I've never cooked the traditional way. So, I'm going to put some of this sauce on the noodles with the meatballs. And I'll leave the Brussels in here for Romel, because that's, I don't think the kids are going to eat that. Gosh, it's so muggy today. What is going on with this weather? Hi, Laura. You love your pasta maker, Sherry? I love mine too. Ever since Tupperware, I have never done pasta on the stovetop ever again. Tell her thank you, Emily. Did you tell her thank you? Okay.
I
Okay.
Thank you.
Leave it right here.
Money!
Yeah. Somebody came and bought my Datsables. So I'm glad because I didn't have to mail it. And she came and picked it up. So I'm just going to put some more of this sauce on it. And then I'm going to sprinkle some Parmesan cheese. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take our kitchen scissors. Should have done it first, but I just thought about it just now. You guys had snow? Oh. Helps the sauce stick on the pasta. Oh, that's good to know. Never knew that. I always learn stuff from you guys. I should have cut the noodles up first, but I didn't think about it until just now. To cut, because the kids are going to eat the spaghetti noodles. And you know what? If Ramel says he wants pasta, I just have to throw more in there and put it in for 15 minutes and it's done. So while all of this dinner was cooking, I was not standing in the kitchen. I was actually folding laundry, feeding the dogs, helping Emily with her homework, and changing the baby's diaper. So I was doing all that other stuff while all this stuff was cooking. Somebody actually commented on an old video of mine that had the chicken orzo soup. You need to laugh desperately, Laura. You might want to go visit Jay's stuff, Instagram. I'm hot today. It is 4:15 over here, Paula. So, what was I going to say now? I forgot what I was going to say. Oh, if Ramel wants more, he can cook it. Oh, because, so somebody shared my, commented on my chicken orzo soup video that I totally forgot that I did a year or two ago. And I look at those videos now and I kind of giggle to myself because that was back when I didn't want to be on the camera. And so I had like a old French press and I balanced my phone on the French press right here in front of me. And then I would like work around it and, do my videos that way. So it's recording what I'm doing and not have me on the camera. And I look at that, I'm just like, my goodness, why would anybody want to watch this? It's so boring. But I was trying to follow like the whole 3-minute shareable delish style BuzzFeed videos. And I don't really get that many views on it. I get more views on these when I'm live with you guys. So that's why I just kept doing my lives. And I've been getting messages asking about the pressure cooker. Because there are people that want the pressure cooker and they don't want to join Tupperware. And you can buy the pressure cooker if you want to. That's an option. It's $149 though. So if you want to buy it, you sure can. Or you can host a party and earn it for free or half off. So those are your options. Or you can join by tomorrow. The promo ends tomorrow. And so when you join, you get the pressure cooker for $15 and that ends tomorrow. So once that ends, the price will go up to $30. Not a bad deal considering it's $149. I personally would much rather spend $15 over $30. And then the modular mate option is there for you too. I cut the meatballs too with the scissors. There's like a couple meatballs that are kind of big still for Emily. So it's still there for you. But then when you join by tomorrow, when you do your first party or submit $500 in orders, doing a party is the easiest way to do it. You get your modular mates for free, and that's every single modular mate in every size with a black cover. So you get that. Hi, Yvette. Hi, Ashley. Hi, Ramel. That means Ramel's on his way home. I hear the... Emily, can you go see outside? I think the FedEx lady is outside. That might be my Tupperware. You know, the ones that I earned. Hey, Emily, can you go check and see if the FedEx lady is honking for us? Please. Where's your sister? Oh, she's sitting down eating Fruit Loops. Hi, Blake. Hi, Hernandez. Can you go see? You want your spaghetti now? Let's try the Brussels. The Brussels sprouts came out so good. Ramel's gonna be happy with this dinner. Super, super happy. So I left everything in big chunks. I didn't cut the Brussels sprouts so that it would be easier to separate them because I'm sure the kids are not going to want. Huh? Okay.
But the box is heavy.
Oh, the box is heavy?
Yeah, it's from Target.
From Target. Oh, it might be like our body wash and stuff like that. Did you guys know that when you subscribe, when you're a subscriber from Target, they give you free shipping and you get 5% off with your red card too? Emily, come try the spaghetti. So I moved all of my orders from Amazon to Target. Come here, Emily, try the spaghetti. Hey, come here with your Baymax. I have your Baymax fork. She has a Baymax fork. Hi, Trinity. Hi, Migdalia. Hi, Chrissy. I cooked the meat with the Brussels sprouts. I put all of this in here and I did it for 15 minutes. And then I did the spaghetti noodles in our pasta maker for 15. So while this was depressurizing, I was cooking the noodles. Emily, how is it? Checking for... Is it good? They need to know how if it's good or bad. Come here, show them. Up or down? Up. Thank you. She said up. Hi, Roland. I was even debating if I should use cream of mushroom with this, because cream of mushroom with this is really good too, but we did cream of mushroom yesterday. So that's why I did tomato base. And then we have an oregano plant outside. I am not using Amazon anymore. I am boycotting Amazon. So if I do my subscription orders, I go through Target. Target offers really good deals on their app. They have the Cartwheel app and all that stuff. So I've transferred all of my subscription stuff, which are like my trash bags, body wash, those things are all coming from Target now. I no longer use Amazon. Emily, here's your food. Come. Come, baby. Baby. Christine. Baby. Okay, she's focused on the television. Come here. Come here. I know. Here, try it. I think it came out really good. What? Thank you, Dawn. I like this hair too. It's so much more manageable.
What, this?
Yeah. No, that was mine because it was sitting under the sauce. Try the one, the Brussels. This? Yeah.
You mixed it with Brussels sprouts?
Try it. Christine is better.
Why, what's wrong with Christine?
She was just fussy.
It's good.
Like, you can eat it with spaghetti noodles if you want, but I don't want pasta. I could have put more Brussels, but I didn't want to, like, overdo it. Is it good?
It's good. Hi, Sherry. Sup, Rollin?
Watch out. Watch out.
It's on the outside.
I know, but I want them gone. See, like, maybe if I hit that fly will start screaming and all the other flies will leave. I don't know, all of a sudden all the flies wanted to come. Yes, that's why I quit Amazon. It's not so much the problems with the review that I did. It's that they completely banned me from reviewing altogether. And I realized, like, what their whole, like, what's the word I'm looking for?
Bias.
No, not bias, because they want you to buy from their Amazon fulfillment versus, like, the actual suppliers. But everything that's on Amazon now is all biased. They tried to eliminate the bias and they ended up conforming all the biases towards the Amazon fulfillment and not from the actual suppliers. So I just stopped going.
Hi, Laura. Hi, Chrissy.
It doesn't really shoot that far. You'd have to be like, I don't know, how many feet is this? 2 feet?
Vitamin E.
Three. Oh,
okay. What's in what?
We should do a tag video.
Do you have...
Gimmick. Yeah, gimmick. Like, whatever their motives are. It's like they tried to, like, sway people from writing biased reviews because suppliers were sending us stuff to try and not everybody was being completely honest, and I get it. But then it just started changing to, it was like, it was almost impossible to write a review
Worse.
Just period.
What?
I don't really like Brussels, but this one actually came out good.
It's like baby cabbage.
I'd rather have regular cabbage. Hi, Johanna. Oh, what do you think of me looking slimmer?
Ooh, what?
Huh? What do you think of me looking slimmer? Give a good answer. Give a good answer. Hmm? What do you think about me being skintier? Or almost skinty?
I love skinny.
So I've lost another 1% of body fat. So I'm down almost 3%.
She lost it and I found it.
But I've lost a lot of inches. I've lost roughly about 1 to 1.5 inches all the way around. I probably lost the most inches around my waistline. And so Coach Steph was like, oh my gosh, I really noticed it the most around my gut. Like now it doesn't really hurt as bad when she has to pinch me with that body fat crap thingy, whatever it's called.
Really?
Yup.
What if I pinch you?
That's not comfortable.
It doesn't really taste like cabbage. It's more bitter, Dawn.
I'm like sweating
Brussels
right now. Super
bacon
hot.
Bacon and balsamic.
Ooh, that does sound good. So I'm gonna go back to the gym tonight. I'm gonna try and make it to Zumba at 6 and a duck class at 7.
Guess who has to watch the kids?
You, yay! It's your turn. Right? Ramel loves me no matter. He loved me when I was big and he'll love me when I'm skinty. Yeah, Ramel. Whatever.
Yeah.
See, everybody says they miss you.
Aww, they like the baby.
Mama.
So yummy. That's why I cut the noodles so baby can eat.
Hi.
Can you guys see me sweating? It's so hot. So I made just enough dinner so we won't have leftovers. Bye, Joe.
So who's going to the Bruno Mars concert?
Yeah, who's going to the Bruno concert? If you're going to the concert, you're probably not watching us. You're either, like, already there or looking for parking. Please send your hand pictures to Ramel and not me. I cannot handle that kind. Like, stitches and stuff like that. She is getting bigger. My memories are coming up when she was littler. And I was like, oh my gosh, uterus started cramping a little bit. You know, like, oh, she has another one?
Everybody's watching them grow.
I know. If you go back, when I first started doing videos, she was still in my belly. Yep, when daddy come home, it's daddy time. Mommy needs a break. Whoop, whoop. Whoop, whoop. Shelly going on Saturday. What is she looking at?
Good luck. What is that?
I don't know, but I'm sweating. I am dripping sweat. It's so hot. What else is there to talk about? I'm trying to think if there was any topics that had come up. Oh, before I forget.
I saw that, Michelle.
What?
Her leftovers.
Oh, what did she make?
So was that Miller Lite in the cup?
Oh my God, that's my jam. bye, Joe. What you call? So Coach Steph was telling me about this Kriper Rooney's. I forgot the name of it. I posted it. It has a picture of a kettlebell where they're doing this 5-week program and you get to work with 5 different coaches.
Mm-mm,
and the class that I'm like super excited to do is Coach Steph's hip-hop dancing class. I can't wait to learn how to hip-hop dance, you know, like pow pow pow.
Did you have complications with Christine?
Did I have complications? Not with the pregnancy, only the delivery. Right, Roland? I swear to God, when she started walking and standing up, we had them like screenshot it because we were live and she was doing it. Remember? We were live and she was like walking for everybody. And now look at her. She's turning into a sassy girl. Like her
Yes,
dad.
She eats very well.
Like her dad.
She can eat this girl.
So good. So good. Oh, water.
Water.
Where's her cup?
In her backpack still?
No.
Oh, How strong are your toes?
Huh?
You said you have strong toes. What? That's gross.
Oh, the bag throw thing? God. Yeah, you're supposed to walk on your freaking toes. Look, Mama's watching. I. More? Okay, more noodles? I apple.
Cover your mouth.
Nay. So when she wants something, she goes like this. Hi, Emily. She goes like that. But she's learning how to say water.
It's getting better, Yvette.
More?
I get the stitches out tomorrow, hopefully.
More?
Hopefully. I'm sick of walking around with this thing. I'm not supposed to get it wet.
More? Okay, more. Daddy's talking. Emily, you want spaghetti? She's eating all yours. Okay. More. She didn't want to take off her dress today. She won't let me take it off. She wants to wear her sexy dress. Look at you. You're over here. Her hair is getting long. Say hi.
Can you cut this little into smaller pieces?
Where's her scissor? The scissor. Pass my scissor. I'm glad that they put these scissors back in the catalog. I think I have like 3 or 4 of them. Because I keep one in my office. I keep one in my glove compartment. Just never know when you're going to need scissors. There.
Can she chew this?
Try.
You want this?
Okay, she wants the noodles.
Okay, there.
Yummy. Do you see yourself? Say hi. Hey. More, please. Daddy is too slow.
Well, my hand is getting tired of holding her.
So yummy. She tries to feed herself. So during the day, I'll let her make a mess. My arms are sore because today Coach Steph made me work my arms this morning using that rope pulling machine thingy. Oh my god. Like, seriously. Let's see how fast if I keep suboing her. Here.
She's saying hi.
Oh, she's saying hi.
She's saying hi.
Say hi. Not good.
Oh! That's a big scoop.
So yummy. She likes it. And this was such a simple recipe. It used very simple ingredients. Those are my favorite kind of recipes. If it's too complicated, I don't want to do it. Like if I look at, you know when, like do you guys do that? So I Google like what am I going to make? And if the list has like more than 7 things on it, I'm like, oh, I don't want to make that. Let's make something else. Yeah, because it's too much. Like salt and pepper, yeah, I get it. Water, that doesn't count. But if it has like all these bougie things on the list, like what you gotta put in it, it's too much. It has to be like regular people food. Yeah, like where you have cream of mushroom, cream of celery, cream of chicken, chicken broth, tomato sauce, that kind. It has to be that kind.
Bye, Mama.
Bye, Mama. Hi, Tracy. I think I missed you. Emily, your TV is too loud. Okay, we're gonna log. I think she's done. Okay, we're gonna log off. Say bye, everyone. We'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye. Say bye. Can you blow a kiss?
Uh-oh.
There's spaghetti everywhere. I have to pick it up. Look, there's Auntie Ren.
Say bye. Blow a kiss.
Bye. Oh, no, no.
What?
She's spitting on her meatball. Can you say bye? Can you blow a kiss? Can you blow a kiss? Can you sing a song?
Cheese.
Cheese. What? I don't know. Okay, bye, everybody.